So my research group uses light microscopes to look at cells and embryos and small organisms as they develop. And one of the challenges in light microscopy is that your normal microscope only uses a single lens to look at the specimen. And so what that means is you can only collect a limited amount of light from the specimen and image it on a camera, you know, to form an image. So the reason that can be a problem in imaging is that limits the amount of signal and also the resolution when you look at a specimen. So one of the advances in our research group is to use more than one lens to look at a specimen. There's a limit, though, to how many lenses you can position around the specimen. And so there's a limit to how much additional information we can get. And the core innovation that we came up with in this work is we realized that if we used a mirror, if we grew the sample on a mirrored coverslip, that mirror would reflect light back to our viewing system in a way that we would normally wouldn't capture that light. And so just like when you look in a mirror, you observe a feature from a different direction and that gives you more information, so too in this innovation do we use a mirrored coverslip to reflect light back that we would normally not observe. So that's the core of the innovation. And then in addition to that, we developed some software that lets us use this light in a convenient fashion. So one of the goals of my lab is to try and understand how the brain forms in simple organisms. And one challenge when doing that is in extracting the most information you can while keeping the light dose pretty low in the sample so you don't destroy the sample as you're looking at it. And I'm excited about this advance because it lets us image these events in brain formation, how the neurons are talking to one another at a spatial and a temporal resolution that is better than the previous state of the art from our lab. I'm also excited because I think this idea of using reflection in microscopy has been somewhat underexplored. So we used it in a particular kind of a microscope that we develop in our lab. I think the same concept could be used to add additional information in other kinds of microscopes as well. And this is one area that we are exploring right now. I think one answer is that nobody has all the answers all the time. So an innovation in biomedical science might happen in one field, and it might even be a pure research field. And then to translate that to the clinic or to make it better, to make it more useful, we rely on a community. We're all kind of in this together. And so we and others at the NIH to try and do everything we can to try and put our discoveries out there so they can be improved upon and built upon. So that's one reason. Another reason as a tool developer is that I want my discoveries to be used by the broad biological biomedical community, and it does me no good if these inventions are kind of locked up in my lab. So I want to make it as easy as possible for others to use my technology, and we try and do this by disseminating the blueprints, by giving away the software, and by having others come and visit our lab so they can improve upon the work that we do.